I'm David from David Christopher's, and today I'm in a beautiful house in Knoxville, Tennessee, on site decorating, and I'm going to be showing you how to apply your decorations to a garland. I've already attached my garland that's pre-lit, and everything you see in our videos is something that we sell, so if you need something, come by the store and check us out or look at our website. The first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and run my ribbon through my garland here. And I'll leave a little bit out at the end that I'll come back to. But you really just want to kind of go in and tuck a piece of pine around your ribbon and just kind of weave in and out so that it doesn't go straight up and down or straight to the sides. That it's got a little variation. You gotta give a little movement. And of course, one thing to remember is good wired ribbon is always an incredible benefit because it is easier to use than unwired ribbon and sheer ribbon and things that just do not work as well. So now that we've got the ribbon evenly distributed up the garland, and we've got four flights of stairs that we have to do, but this is the main level. So this one we want to get a little bit more of something at the end cap here, and I'm just going to do a little bow, not a huge one, just something small so that we get a little more impact on the main floor here. And then you have a couple options here. You can always kind of curl the ribbon, fold it on itself and curl it up, or we can cut tails in the ribbon. Sometimes you might need a little extra long piece right here, but I think this is gonna work just fine like this. And then I'm gonna add some stems and ornaments to the garland. Okay, now we're ready to move on to our stems and sprays and ornaments portion of adding to our garland. I've just got some various things picked out here. And we're gonna add, similar to the ribbon, kind of inside, outside, but you wanna make sure that the stem goes up with the garland so that it doesn't show, but it kind of tucks in right inside those green stems, and you'll never notice the out, the back end of the stem here. And I like to finish about every single piece of one style so that I make sure the color is balanced throughout the garland before I move on to another stem. The other thing I like to do is I do like to twist a piece of the garland pine around the stem so that somebody walking by that wants to grab at the rail is not going to pull that out. It's not going to come out until you're ready. Okay, now we're going to add just a little touch of gold into this garland. There's a little bit of gold in our ribbon right here. So this wispy ball spray will work nicely. Kind of keeping in the same way, we just added the green stem. I just want to kind of go in between the green stem. I don't want it on top of the green. I just want it in between so that you get a little bit more show out of it. If you add everything on top of each other, you see more clusters instead of it separated and spread, distributed evenly through the garland. And don't forget that good wired stems you can always place in the garland, twist a piece of pine around them, and then bend them in the direction you want them to go. And they should stay where you put them. And if you don't know how many pieces you're going to use, if you haven't done a couple thousand garlands in your lifetime, it's always better to have a little more than you need in case you run out, because it does start to look a little odd if you get to a place and you run out of something. And the rest of it's very evenly distributed. We're going to continue the same process with the metallic red berry stem. Garland. this is the main floor and this is the focal point where everyone will first see the garland, we want to embellish the end cap here just a little bit more with some stems. Show you the easiest way to keep things that are hanging low like this from coming down is if we put a little bend in the back of the stem, and then once you go past the garland, just make sure it hooks onto the garland and it's not going to go anywhere. And we're going to hang another ornament here at the bottom with just some wire. And so we hope you've learned something today about how you can properly decorate your staircase and mantle and things like that. And be ready for your do-it-yourself project. We have everything that you need and more at David Christopher's.